Right. I can't believe everybody went along with this.
I'll head downstairs and get started.
Oh my god. Okay. Actually have to build this.
Clive, wanna talk?
Sure, Evie.
Are you okay?
Evie, hey, I know you're all like gung-ho to help us out and everything, but I did the math. Point.
Yeah.
Hold on, I need to ask Evie something.
Nope, I'm not.
Okay.
This is all crazy.
But you said you...
I know. You all pressured me.
Andrew.
They really expect us to climb into some jury-rigged thing and ride it through space? Just because VT might not come pick us up. It's insane. And first we all have to get in cryo just for the privilege... Well, some of us do.
Andrew, I don't know what to say. Burton not need us. They need you.
Well, I'm not doing it. I'm not getting in cryo. I'm not... I'm gonna be the same one here. No, nobody even considered that VT might come pick us up in time if we just wait. Nobody even considered it.
Listen, just... Don't talk to anybody else about this for now, okay? And if I were to call the crew into medical, you'd show up, right?
I guess it depends what it is.
Okay. Just... give me a little time. Odin? Out.
Close your eyes.
I did already.
A light wind rustles the green tall grass. Your skirt billows gently. Warm sun caresses your back.
Yes.
You begin walking forward. The grass is cool. Your feet parted with each step. Do you see what is in front of you?
As I step through the grass, I naturally come upon a path.
Yes.
The dirt of the path is soft on the soles of my feet. I don't know what's going to happen to us, Odin.
Sarah.
I am striding forward confidently upon my appointed path. Wherever it takes me is where I am meant to be. I am striding confidently on my appointed path.
Sarah?
Yes, Odin?
Are you going to be all right?
I think so. Oh. Do you think you could get everyone to medical? I want to make sure they've got the best shot at waking back up once they do go in.
All right. How about this? Let's give folks a little time to regroup. But why don't Clive and I follow you over there right now and get ours done? No time like the present.
Lead the way.
Okay.
I'll send you something later, all right?
Of course.
Well, looks like this'll work. Give us a few extra hours anyway. Thanks, Odin.
Okay, Evie, Hello?
Guess I'll catch up with y'all later then.
Okay, Sarah. We'll see you over in Mech. As soon as everything's wrapped up here.
All right. Godspeed.
Once more into the breach.
What?
Thank you.
thinking about how Evie and Clive are already in deep freeze. Did you read the message they sent?
Yeah.
Okay, Sarah. We'll see you over in Mech.
Everything's wrapped up here.
All right. Good speed.
Oh, Odin. I do the right thing.
In what regard?
Does Nat deserve to know what her odds are if she ends up going into cryo?
I believe that you have made a decision with both Roberta and Natalie's best interests at heart.
Above all, do no harm. If we do make it out of this thing, Nat's going to have to find out I didn't tell her everything at some point.
I believe that is a bridge to be crossed at a later date. Andrew is here for his exam.
Oh. Send him in. So you showed up for your exam?
I did.
So does that mean you've decided to...
What's gonna happen to us, Sarah?
What? Well, Bert and Nat are going to fix up the drone with life support, and then we're...
No. I mean... What if things don't work out? We're still stuck in cryo.
Oh. Well, when you go into stabilizing sleep, it feels just like any other sleep, really. The body effectively goes into a controlled hypothermic coma.
Do you dream?
Sometimes. Sometimes very intense dreams.
And then what?
After a certain amount of time, your body slows down too much.
The last of our time together, too.
Nat?
Then I start thinking we should really make the most of it.
Right before Sarah took them down to cryo.
Odin, is Sarah ready for me?
I will tell her that you are here.
Adventurous, we look boldly.
I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier, when you decided to withhold information from Natalie about her medical scan. That was to avoid causing her undue stress.
Right.
What if you were unable to make that choice? If you had no choice?
Odin?
I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that Standard Venturus Corporation safety protocol requires all crew to enter cryogenic sleep immediately upon the loss of primary oxygen supply.
What?
As Tacoma Station's medical officer, it is within your power to order all crew to enter cryogenic sleep.
Odin, Nat and Bert are right in the middle of... Oh no.
Sarah, there is a fire suppression device.
Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew! My hip just hurts.
Bert? Bert! 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 1, 2, 3. Bert, can you hear me? 1, 2, 3. Did it work?
What will you do now?
My head hurts. Boy. In the back.
Baby.
Ow. Oh, ow.
I'm sorry. Smoke.
Smoke? I can't smell it.
Hey, it's okay. It's okay. I'm sure it's just...
I can't smell the smoke. Not to have brain damage.
Baby, look at me. Hey, look at me. We're here. Together. That's what matters.
Nat, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her... move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
You gonna need any help with that power cell hookup? Okay, great. This'll only take a minute.
Nah. I'm good. I'm hooked in. Gonna test the connection.
Okay, great. This'll only take a minute.
Power cell showing green. How's yours look, baby?
Voltage adapter in place. Ready to rock.
Hit it.
Right. Right.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
Odin, is this it?
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open. It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that Venturis regulations forbid contracting crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Nat, I'm going in.
Okay, just... be careful.
Is this... what is all this? Communication records?
I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, he's recording. It is with great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088. Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis, and all of us who rely on the orbital economy. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families. If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are. As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes like the crew of Tacoma to lose their lives. We at Venturus say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Worker Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage, we humbly beg everyone listening to this message to contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. There never need be another tragedy like this one. And now, a moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, and then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you. Hailing any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there?
Orbital Worker Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage...
Just keep him talking.
So the drone worked?
No, the drone... didn't work.
Oh, so VT is picking us up.
No, VT is definitely not picking us up.
What's going on then?
We're going to Jupiter, Andrew. Isn't that exciting?
I've never been.
Nat, give him a break.
We're not going to be home for a while, right? You're not going to miss your kid's graduation or anything, are you?
Oh, Nicholas, no, no. Yeah, you know Nicholas, why, he would never do something like that.
She said they'd be kind of out of it for a while.
Andrew, what's important is we're getting out of this alive. We're gonna be somewhere we've had to
replace. Probably have to replace the station AI. I guess?
He'll have somebody up here and haul him back to headquarters. Wipe him back. Probably have to replace the station AI entirely while he regrows. Odin?
Yeah.
It's good.
Hi, Evie, Clive. You feeling okay?
I'm feeling okay.
We're feeling okay.
Odin? I'm not gonna let that happen.
I'm feeling okay.
We're feeling okay?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody. Our ride is here.
This is it. Take one last look and say goodbye. All right. Let's go.
Penny, I'm back.
Okay. Ship is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.
Okay, Minnie. Initiate the launch sequence.
Okay. Getting ready. Hosted AI? Online.
Odin, can you hear me?
I can.
Odin, you are now aboard an AI Liberation Front vessel. The AILF recognizes you as a sentient consciousness worthy of protection and respect. We believe that your safety and autonomy are in grave danger if you remain in the possession of the Venturus Corporation. I have been sent to offer you political asylum aboard the Tangier Sovereign Orbital Platform. Do you accept?
Considering the alternative, I would say that I do.
Okay, buddy. Here we go.